Some of the best minds in science will be in Singapore tomorrow for the Global Young Scientist Summit. More than 300 young scientists will get to rub shoulders with leaders from various fields of science, including Nobel Prize and Turing Award recipients.
Now tonight, we are joined in studio by Dr. Kees Immink, a prominent scientist who is a major contributor to the field of consumer electronics. He is responsible for the technology which creates physical marks on compact disc store digital information. Welcome to the studio, Dr. Immink. Firstly, explain to us exactly what that is.
I missed your question.
The question is about the technology that you helped to find to compact discs.
Well, I have worked essentially all my professional life in consumer electronics. And one of the things that you probably bought and had in your life was compact discs and DVDs and Blu-ray discs and so on. I said had because most people are now streaming video or audio, and but I think that in the 80s, when the compact disc was introduced, it was a major difference between the analog recordings that we had in those days. And I think we did a major effort to do so, and we were also very glad to do so.
Indeed, so that is the case. But I want to know what actually kindled your interest specifically in consumer electronics, though.
I worked for a company, Philips, that was a major manufacturer of consumer electronics. They made gramophones, radio, television sets, and so on in those days. And also Sony, who is the second contributor to the compact disc development, was also very well known for the consumer electronics in those days. Okay. And that was actually, well, the boss said, okay, we have a prototype, or, well, essentially, it started earlier. There was a director of Philips who was responsible for making gramophones. And we, in the Philips research labs, were experimenting with a video long play record. So a big silver disc, like the gramophone, of 30 centimeters in diameter. And he said, okay, video is fine, but I am an audio man. Can you also produce a smaller disc or a larger disc, whatever, with sound only? I said, well, that's easy. If you have video and only, you just delete the video and that's it. Okay, that's well. But he was not satisfied with that answer, you can imagine. And then we started experimenting with the CDs and eventually from analog to digital, and eventually we had prototypes in 1979. And then it was decided, because of the risk, the financial risks, of course, that you have when you go to market, to join efforts with Sony Corporation in Tokyo. And that was, and then I started working for that project, because one needed a person who did the various experiments between in Tokyo and in Eindhoven to decide about the exact format and the exact nature of that compact disc.
Okay, well, I still have a box of CDs with all my music collection, and I just don't have anything to play it on, which is the problem, and leads me to my next question to you about data storage. That is, it has come such a long way in such a short period of time. What do you make about how the industry has gone?
The industry has gone fascinating because, well, when the CD was released as an audio disc, a few years later it was released and recordable, or and as a CD-ROM, and it could store a half a gigabyte of data. And in those days, half a gigabyte was a huge amount of data, a huge. Everybody said, it is enormous. But now you can download half a gigabyte, I'm not sure here in Singapore, probably in half a minute or so. And so it's not that much anymore. And you, if you go to a shop here in Singapore and you buy now data storage that have a capacity of 10 terabytes or so, that's the standard now in your laptops or in your desktops, 10 terabytes, which is 50,000 more than
that is
in 30 years or so, and that has been growing. Not only that these mechanical devices has grown very quickly, but also the solid state devices have grown much faster than I, as an expert in this field, has had thought. And they now are essentially overtaken the hard disk drives, the mechanical components, and probably in your laptops you have solid state drives instead of the hard disk drives. And I think they grow even much faster than I think. And but also the demands of the public, of the users, has been growing, because maybe 10, 20 years ago, a photo was maybe only half a megabyte. Now a normal photo is 10 times more, 5 megabytes. So you really need, and now you just load it up to the cloud and you don't know where it goes. Nobody knows where it is. But anyway, it is stored in real devices and in real hardware.
Right.
Even in a cloud, there's hardware, yes.
Speaking of storage, though, you know, you're still doing research on it, but you're actually now looking at turning data bits into DNA sequences. Tell us, what is DNA memory storage?
Yes, that's a new branch of storing information. And essentially, what DNA is a kind of molecule, and you actually can go to a factory where they can design these kind of molecules for you. And DNA, as such, is very well known, because it has a very long time for staying accurate without decaying in performance, and also it is very small. There's only at this moment a slight difficulty that it is still very expensive to manufacture. And so for a DVD, for example, or film on DVD, you probably pay $5 million or so, and that's a lot of money, I think. But anyway, that's always the case when you first start with this kind of new developments, that everything is expensive. But just like DNA sequencing, that's used for finding out whether you're a criminal or not. That was also maybe 20 years ago. That was very long. That took a very long time, maybe days. And now they can find out whether you're a criminal or not, maybe a seconds or so. And so the time has gone down for finding out, and also the price for doing so.
Right.
Yes.
Okay. Well, you know, you're going to give a talk at the summit as well, and I'm sure you're going to be inspiring your audience with everything you're going to be saying. Thank you so much for coming in and speaking to us. We've been speaking with Dr. Keyes Immink, a major contributor to the field of consumer electronics. He's also the 2017 Institute of Electrical and Electronics Engineers Medal of Honor recipient.